As for me, I trust in the Lord. Let me be glad and rejoice in your mercy, for you have seen my affliction. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us call to mind our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. I confess.
Lord, to God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, your Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May the Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And let us pray. O God, who renew the world through mysteries beyond all telling, grant, we pray, that your church may be guided by your eternal design and not be deprived of your help in this present age. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, Lo, I am about to create new heavens and a new earth. The things of the past shall not be remembered or come to mind. Instead, there shall always be rejoicing and happiness in what I create. For I create Jerusalem to be a joy and its people to be a delight. I will rejoice in Jerusalem and exalt in my people. No longer shall the sound of weeping be heard there, or the sound of crying. No longer shall there be in it an infant who lives but a few days, or an old man who does not round out his full lifetime. He dies a mere youth, who reaches but 100 years, and he who fails of 100 shall be thought accursed. They shall live in the houses they build, and eat the fruit of the vineyards they plant. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I will praise you, Lord, for you have rescued me.
I will praise you, Lord, for you have rescued me.
I will extol you, O Lord, for you drew me clear and did not let my enemies rejoice over me. O Lord, you brought me up from the netherworld. You preserved me from among those going down into the pit. I will praise you, Lord, for you have rescued me. Sing praise to the Lord, you his faithful ones, and give thanks to his holy name. For his anger lasts but a moment, a lifetime his goodwill. At nightfall, weeping enters in, but with the dawn, rejoicing. I will praise you, Lord, for you have rescued me. Hear, O Lord, and have pity on me. O Lord, be my helper. You change my mourning into dancing. O Lord, my God, forever will I give you thanks. I will praise you, Lord, for you have rescued me.
Glory and praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Glory and praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Seek good and not evil, that you may live and the Lord will be with you.
Glory and praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory.
glory to you, Lord.
At that time, Jesus left Samaria for Galilee, for Jesus himself testified that a prophet has no honor in his native place. When he came to Galilee, the Galileans welcomed him, since they had seen all that he had done in Jerusalem at the feast, for they themselves had gone to the feast. Then he returned to Canaan in Galilee, where he made water wine. Now there was a royal official whose son was ill in Capernaum. When he heard that Jesus had arrived in Galilee from Judea, he went to him and asked him to come down and heal his son who was near death. Jesus said to him, "Unless you people see signs and wonders, you will not believe." The royal official said to him, "Sir, come down before my child dies." Jesus said to him, "You may go, your son will live." The man believed what Jesus had said to him and left. While the man was still on his way back, his slaves met him and told him that his boy would live. He asked them when he began to recover. They told him, "The fever lessened yesterday about 1 p.m. The father realized that at that time Jesus had said to him, "Your son will live." And he and his whole household came to believe in him. Now this was the second sign Jesus did when he came to Galilee from Judea. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good morning. In the midst of the coronavirus, we can get great wisdom from the gospel passage that we heard today. The man running up to Jesus, "Jesus, the one whom can bring healing." And he runs up to him and asks for his son to be healed. We too can turn to the Lord in our prayer and our encouragement should be turning to the Lord in our prayer. Perpetually going before his holy throne, asking for his grace, asking for healing for those in need, asking for an end to health pandemic going on, asking for his grace. There's a beautiful prayer called "The Prayer of an Epidemic" by Carrie Weber from American Magazine that I'd like to share with all of us today. A prayer that we can all unite our hearts to as we then unite to the Sacred Heart of the Lord. Jesus Christ, you travel through towns and villages, curing every disease and illness. At your command, the sick were made well. Come to our aid now, in the midst of the global spread of the coronavirus, that we may experience your healing love. Heal those who are sick with the virus. May they regain their strength and health through quality medical care. Heal us from our fear, which prevents nations from working together and neighbors from helping one another. Heal us from our pride, which can make us claim invulnerability to a disease that knows no borders. Jesus Christ, healer of all, stay by our side in this time of uncertainty and sorrow. Be with those who have died from the virus. May they be at rest with you in your eternal peace. Be with the families of those who are sick or have died. As they worry and grieve, defend them from illness and despair. May they know your peace. Be with the doctors, nurses, researchers, and all medical professionals who seek to heal and help those affected and who put themselves at risk in the process. May they know your protection and peace. Be with the leaders of all nations. Give them the foresight to act with charity and true concern for the well-being of the people they are meant to serve. Give them the wisdom to invest in long-term solutions that will help prepare for or prevent future outbreaks. May they know your peace as they work together to achieve it on earth. Whether we are home or abroad, surrounded by many people suffering from this illness, or only a few, Jesus Christ, stay with us as we endure and mourn, persist and prepare. In place of our anxiety, give us your peace. Jesus Christ, heal us. Amen.
Let us now present our prayers and petitions to our loving Father. God of wisdom, we ask you to guide the Pope, the bishops, and the pastors throughout the world, that they may make right decisions for the well-being of the people. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for our government leaders who have to make decisions on what needs to be done. We pray that these decisions are always for the good of the people. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for compassion and concern for others, that we may look after each other in these challenging times, especially those among us who are vulnerable. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God of strength, accompany those who save us with love and generosity in the medical profession. We ask you to bless them, to strengthen them, and guide them with your abundant goodness. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the parishioners of St. Peter and Paul, so that they may be confident in your loving presence among them and in every moment of their lives. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For today's mass intentions, for Manda Dasein, Tony Tobias, and the intentions of D. DeVos, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God, our Father, we place ourselves and the world in your protection and love as we bring these prayers through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise of your advancement, for our good and all of the church.
May we receive, O Lord, we pray, the effects of this offering dedicated to you, so that we may be cleansed from all earthly ways and be renewed by growth in heavenly life. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you will that our self-denial should give you thanks, humble our sinful pride, contribute to the feeding of the poor, and so help us imitate you in your kindness. And so we glorify you with countless angels, as with one voice of praise we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fountain of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith.
Savior of the world, by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Daniel, our Bishop, and Richard, our Apostolic Administrator, and all the clergy.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with Saints Peter and Paul, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who say to your apostles, peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter my room, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
For those of us who are following this from home and cannot receive the body and blood of Christ, we pray now for our spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already here and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Thank you.
holy gifts, O Lord, we pray, give us life by making us new, and by sanctifying us, lead us to things eternal, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.